I'm going to be doing the spark plugs. This is the 3.5 VTEC engine. And I got to take this cover off. And to take this cover, there's 4 10 millimeter bolts. There's one here, one here, one here. I already loosened them, and one here. So you just take this cover out. Then you got to pop this other cover that's right here with a screwdriver. Just turn it halfway. One here and one here, guys. So let's get to it. This cover's just loose because I had loosened it already. Okay. Let me see where I put my little I just had the other key in my hand. You see it right there. So, guys, see if you can see here. Now, to take these coil wires out, all you have to do is just right here squeeze and they should come up, and this one too, and this one here. So you just squeeze right here and it pops up like that. You see, it has a tab right here on the side right here. So I'm gonna be doing that. Oh, also, this is a 6 millimeter Allen wrench. You got to use one of these to remove the coil screw here. There's 3 of them right here. You just put the Allen key right here. Right there, guys. I already loosened this one. I loosened the middle one, I think it was. Right there. It comes out, guys. So that's what we're gonna do. So there's 3 in the front and 3 in the back. So this is the little screw, guys. Just like that. Now I'm hoping I don't have to go back upstairs and get another extension. So this is the coil. And also, guys, these are the spark plugs we're going to be using. These are the Bosch Double Platinum. The part number is 8105. And these spark plugs, the good thing about it, you don't have to gap them. And it says do not add anti-seize. That's what it says on the box here. So you can see right there, it says it on the box. Hope you can see that, because letters are kind of small. So they already come pre-gapped, which is a good thing. Good. Burning good. Okay, so here we go. See, they're the same. Mm-hmm. Always got to make sure, because they got longer ones. No, this one was loose too. Look. Oh no, this is the one that I loosened before. Yeah, this was the one that I put the Allen key here to see if it fits. I can't believe this engine is still hot. I don't know if it's because of the sun or... Because this is what, it passed like what, like an hour, I think?
More than that?
Yeah. And also, guys, the socket, it's 5/8. It's the one you're going to use. I use the one with the little rubber inside, because there's people that use one with a magnet. So I took out the first three, put this little Allen screw back in here. Snug them down and move to the three in the back. Now don't tighten these too hard, just snug them down, guys. So let's move to the next three. Now, I already put the wire in, connector, and I tightened this down so everything is nice and snug. So now, let's go to the back. Let me see if I can put you guys in another direction here, hopefully. I'm gonna try. I can get you guys down here somewhere. Might not be a very good view, guys, but I don't have too much room back here, so I'm gonna do the best that I can to show you what's going on. And I have to just leave you guys right here. But it's the same process as in the front, guys. Take out the little Allen screw. There's one here, and one here. There's three back there. Let me get another glove, because this glove is already broken down.
I'm working. I'm going to take my belly. All right.
Okay, guys, so.
Oh, that's right, because you don't work with black delegates. A lot of those new guys, they don't know you.
Yeah. Let me loosen this up. Here we go.
Adam, I'll go put the water in the car.
Let me get it. I'm going to open it now.
Okay.
Just want to put this here because it's a little hot there.
Yeah. You want a second one?
What?
I have more.
No, that's fine. That's fine. It's better to leave it here because it got ice. It could break
up. Okay.
It could melt down that ice a little bit.
Okay.
So here we don't have too much space, guys, so we just got to do this little by little. The space back here is limited. So we just gotta take our time. But it'll come out. Just gonna be a little slower, that's all. So I took out the screw. Here goes the coil. So here we go, guys. This is one. Where are you putting them at? Just put them here?
Yeah, yeah.
take out the second one. Also, guys, stay tuned, because after this, I'm going to do a oil change on this same car. Engine oil change and the filter. Oh, shit. At least it fell on the floor, so it's okay.
You're not working on the ship.
Yeah, because sometimes it gets stuck, like, in between the engine and, you know, you don't want to do that. And it's hard to get to, you know? Yeah.
I was thinking about the same thing.
Thanks. Thanks, bro.
See? I know it's coming in handy.
Yeah, it comes in handy. Okay, guys, so let's finish taking out that spark plug.
See, this one burned bad.
It's not bad, it's not too bad.
It's a lot of heat.
Yeah. So after this one, we just got one more, guys. So remember, guys, take your time. Don't rush nothing because you don't want to break nothing. And everything should be okay.
Burning out.
Think so?
See that black? You got black in there?
Yeah. Yeah, but they're not wet or anything, so.
Yeah, that's a good thing. If it's wet, then
It's
messed up.
No, not really. It could be something else. It could be your. Sometimes when oil goes in there, it could be the valve covers.
The gasket, yeah.
Okay, so now we got to tighten all the screws back, all the Allen screws. Make sure you plug everything back, and you should be good. So that's the...